Hello and a very warm welcome, viewers. You're watching the brand new edition of India Fights Back with your host, Kriti Mishra. India held a virtual global conclave of representatives from the health and technology domains from various countries to share details of its COVID-19 vaccination platform, COVIN. COVIN is an extension of Electronic Vaccine Intelligence Network, EVIN, which is used to collect real-time feedback of the vaccination program. COVIN is a cloud-based IT solution for planning, implementing, monitoring and evaluating COVID-19 vaccination in the country. According to the operational guidelines by COVID-19 vaccination prepared by the Union Health Ministry, the COVIN system on a real-time basis tracks not only the beneficiaries but also the vaccines at the national, state and district levels. It also monitors the utilization, wastage and coverage of vaccination. Also, every detail from the site where vaccination is carried out to the number of beneficiaries and even the batch number, doses per vial and schedule of the vaccine is uploaded on COVID. And for deeper insights on this, I'm joined by Dr. E. Venkat Rao, member, Odisha State Advisory Committee on COVID-19, and Dr. Sunil Raina, professor and head, Community Medicine, Dr. R.P. Government Medical College, Tanda, in the state of Himachal Pradesh. Welcome to Sunset TV, both of you, and thank you so much for joining us. And Dr. Rao, coming to
thank you first. Sir.
Prime Minister addressed the COVIN Global Conclave. Union government has decided to make COVIN available to any other country desirous to use the platform for managing their vaccination program in their country. Your opening thoughts, sir?
See, as our Honorable Prime Minister mentioned that, in Hindu mythology, it says that Vasudevakam Kutumbakam, that is the whole globe, is a single family. And time and again, we have seen that a disease never follows any borders. A disease at any corner of the country is a threat to the other rest of the world. Now, India is playing a pivotal role in this particular control mechanism for the simple reason that if there is a threat in any corner of the country, it can spread to the rest of the world. And for this situation of this pandemic has taught us that we need to be playing a combined strategy. And for that, all the resources developed from any corner of the country should be pulled together to take care of this situation. And one of the biggest invention or creation or whatever you call it is our COVIN. Such a huge scale platform, digital platform to monitor the vaccination of the world's second biggest populous country. And this can be a game changer because it can handle or monitor, evaluate, and policy making also, it can be possible. And that platform now, it has been made open source and rest of the world can also play it, use it. And so that global data can be generated and better evidence-based planning can be made. So this is a very big...
Yes, sir. Yeah. You made an important point about evidence-based planning. And as we know, that data is very important as far as handling this situation or handling this pandemic is concerned. Dr. Raina, as Dr. Rao was telling us, made in India, COVIN is going to go global. What are your thoughts?
First, Kriti, thanks for having me on the show. If you look at this pandemic has thrown up some very good lessons for us. And one of the key lessons that is true for us was that this pandemic has influenced every country, impacted every country in almost equal measures. So there are not many great winners from this pandemic at this point in time. But there are not good models also. So you couldn't say to one country that we learn from some other country and we can apply that model in our own country and then benefit from that model. India is really placed in a very good situation at this point, because if India wins and if India is successful and if India is able to develop a model of care, model of system, which will be applicable to everybody across the world, then it's a win-win situation for all because of the size that India offers, because of the diversity that India has. So if we are able to develop a model or a system which is applicable or which does find application in other countries, particularly the low and middle income countries, it's a welcome step. That's what the global demand or the global outreach or the global impact of this app will be, this application will have. But beyond that, we also need to think about the first perspectives or the first impressions of this application, whether this application was needed, yes or no. So we need to understand that this application at initial stages was imperative. It was something which was not created in a way to send it to the global world, but created because we needed it the most. We were in dire need of having an application which could drive our vaccination program. If you realize that India's vaccination program was run in an emergency authorization mode, had to have a framework for itself to run, and for that framework, technology was the key. And that technology was driven by an application like Covin, or before that by what we did with our Aarogya Setu app. So these are something that we have been developing over a period of time, and the world can learn from them, world can take them, world can use them. So in that, as Dr. Rao said, that Vasudeva Kutumbakam, or the fact that the whole world is us, or is a family, our contribution to the world, at least to the low and middle income countries, in being able to provide such a valuable app, will go a long way in developing an effective strategy in combating this pandemic. So that's the way forward for the world, to launch to it, to hang on to it and take it up as soon as possible.
And as you were saying, that it could be a game changer, and of course now it is an open source. Dr. Rao, the Covin platform for vaccination is unique in the world in terms of probability, scalability and inclusivity. Tell us about the features that set it apart.
See, one important thing is, in any planning, any activity, let it be an immunization or a treatment protocol or anything, where you require a wide ramifications, like wide dissemination, if you require, in the today's days, the use of the IT, information technology. Now, this digital world has been made it possible that, yes, in a large scale, you can do that. And initial glitches, whatever we have observed during the, let it be maybe the Aarogya Setu app or maybe the Covin app. I mean, many media messages, they kept on cropping up. They're saying that the app is crashing, the appointments are not possible. And such a, so many crisis situations had come up in the past. But now we have graduated with the same reason that now it is scalable. The initial glitches we have been able to overcome, and now it is scalable to a large, any country or any community. Earlier, what we had done in India was running the biggest immunization program, that is for under 5 children and mothers. Maybe the total population, whatever the current populations, 5 to 10% of the population probably we were handling with a lot of difficulty. And that time, the need was never perceived. Now, with this scalable immunization for the whole country, 140 crore population when it to be given, it was, I think, without a digital world. And Covin has made it that. Now, if we could have scale it from a 10% to 100%, then why not to the whole of the globe? Yes, it is sustainable. And this is the need of the today's world. At any given junction, you know very well that data is gold. And gold need not be sold in the market, but it can be distributed. But wherever you are having it, it is likely to achieve a good dividend. And India is doing that. We are forerunners in this scenario.
All right, so we are the front runners, but you made a very important remark there saying that we have graduated. Dr. Raina, we've graduated, and that too with flying colors. 300 million plus registrations, vaccinations with granular details of each individual that is available on the portal.
Absolutely. I think this was a test as well as a lead up to what we believe we could do for the world. I always keep saying that this world in future will be led by the data. And if you have good data, and if you have good databases, you will be leading the world. Because nothing without data will be considered evidence-based, and nothing without data will be considered significant. So you have to have both these things. You have to have evidence-based, and you have to have significant evidence-based. And to drive a significant evidence-based, you have to have a good data. And that good data has to be put upon a good database. And I think this application has been a win-win situation in that way. because we have been able to prove that, to prove to the world that we can build a good database system, and that good database system can load on it a lot of data, which is scalable, sustainable, which can be upgraded to higher versions, and which can put on itself a lot of load and still be useful and applicable to all people around the world. So in that sense, this is very important and has huge ramifications as far as India is concerned. Now, India has, if you look at the past 5-10 years, India has been talking of being a data-driven country. It has been saying that, that the data should be the one which should drive all its policies, whether they are in the realm of health or whether they are in the realm of other spheres of the world. So they think that the data should be the one that should be driving all of these policy directives or policy initiatives. And in that sense, if we are thinking of developing a database which is good enough to be launched up as a world-based database or applicable to around people around the world, in that sense, it's a good good bargain to have. And putting India itself into such a situation wherein people can launch into this is something that is a win-win situation. And I'm hopeful that we will continue to use this data, and we will continue to use this data for a better purpose. As you said, this, at this point in time, we are able to track the data with regard to vaccination, with regard to the doses which have been used or doses which have been missed, or with regard to whether there has been a vaccine wastage, or whether with regard to whether where exactly will the vaccines be available. So that's something which is limited to this particular vaccination program. I am looking at an extension of this particular database to other spheres of health as well, or probably looking at similar databases in other spheres of health. So in that situation, probably this is the first step, the initial step, and this step, if it is successful in attracting people across the world, means that we are ready to lead the world as far as data is concerned, data-driven policies are concerned. So that's something which we always looked for, and this is something that this government has been saying for a long period of time, and this is always something which is of a welcome nature for all of us.
All right, so you said that we are ready for a data-driven policy, but I'll just speak to you about the concerns on data in just a bit. But before that, Dr. Rao, one of the most remarkable features for me is that it is a very citizen-centric platform. Certainly, this has made the entire process very hassle-free, and it has become very seamless.
Yeah, absolutely. See, let's see this particular thing in a different perspective. In the current pandemic, has really put us on our knees. Like, it has caused so much of morbidity, mortality, and economy loss and everything. But this has taught us, we can say that it is a positive perspective. It's a blessing in disguise. When this Aadhaar system was introduced, that time there were different schools of thoughts saying that every citizen in the country should have a unique ID, where it should be the state-driven, district-driven, block-driven. It's like 2-2 digits for each thing. And gradually it evolved that we should have a Aadhaar system. Now, in the same way, Aadhaar was implemented, but there were several bottlenecks before Aadhaar's full potential could be explored. Now what is happening is this pandemic situation, now we are trying to link up this Aadhaar with this the vaccination platform. Now, what we are looking for is, if you go to any small countries, say India is a very vast country. If you go to any very small countries, developed nations, they have a small population, but all their health data is compact. Electronic health record systems, yes, they have pretty well sustainable ones. Now, this is a first step to bring about to such a level that, yes, we have come up. If it has to be citizen-centric and hassle-free, and we have been able to put across that, yes, it is doable. Now, it is Aadhaar-linked, and the days are not far away that we graduate still further and to a still higher level. So it's a very beautiful situation what is being brought up. Yeah.
Yes, sir. But Dr. Raina, you were talking about the concerns. Of course, you were talking about data, but before the COWIN platform was unveiled, I remember there was this debate on data security, on privacy. Do you think those issues are settled now?
Yes, most of these issues are settled now. You look, when we talk of data, or when we talk of data being taken up by the government, in a sense that they develop a platform in which data will be put, these questions will always arise. But you look at the better side of it. I give an example. At this point in time, when I am planning for purpose of health, for example, I use two basic databases. I use the census database, or I use the sample registration system database, or lately we use the National Family Health Survey database. If you look at the census database, the database is of the year 2011. We don't have a robust real-time database as far as census is concerned. If you look at the SRS database, again, that is not very real-time robust data available to us in the real-time scenario as of yesterday's data. Or if you look at the National Family Health Survey data, now once it comes into the print form and once it's uploaded on the platform, the data collection time has gone by 2 years. So whatever has been collected 2 or 3 years back is put up on the portals now. So the key is to have real-time data if I am to plan now. This pandemic has taught us this very basic thing, that if I am to plan anything in an eventual situation or in a situation of crisis, I have to have real-time data, which is available to me at the hand of my finger. It should be available to me now. I can't rely on a database which is 10 years old. So as far as that part is concerned, every data which is made available to platforms is useful, because it all in all, at the last end, it will be useful to the country as a whole. It will be available to all the people of the country. Unless and until there are very serious issues with regard to data security. I have been listening to it. I have been seeing it. I have been using this platform, and I am really not concerned about the data security, because the data that you are putting on CoVINAP, for example, is the data that is already being put up on other platforms as well. When you submitted your Aadhaar data for the Aadhaar card, for example, most of the data is already available on that platform as well. So making the similar data available on this platform doesn't make any sense when we talk of data breach or data security. And I think most of these questions have been addressed by the government from time to time with regard to the data being secure and whether with regard to no data being breached as far as this platform is concerned. But as I said previously as well, the development of a platform to deal with this vaccination program was mandatory for us. It was not something that we did out of choice, that we wanted this to help us. This was something which was mandatory for us because we were going into a framework of delivering vaccination. We were having an authorized vaccination system which was to be delivered through a framework. And a framework developed dependent authorization had to have a technology base with it. And that is why we developed this technology. The fact that it has been useful to us, and the fact that it can be scaled up, and the fact that it can be used by others is the second part of it. So if you again look at it, if you don't have such a platform, you always have people who can make use of this, the vaccination program and have their ulterior motives to subvert the program as such. You have seen some reports that came from the Maharashtra itself. So unless and until you have a robust database, and that robust database dictates the authorized delivery of vaccines, we would not have been able to vaccinate the number of people that we have been at this point in time. So I think the concerns raised with regard to data breach are not very valid and are probably exaggerated. And the fact that we can't live without data, it's something like that. You tell me that the petrol is 100 rupees a day or 70 rupees a day, so you would not you will stop driving your car. It's something like that. So the data is there, it has to be put there, and it has to be made use of by everybody.
All right, so as you're saying that this data is absolutely secure, but Dr. Rao, you were talking about upgrading this platform. Now, I do hope that this pandemic, we gain emancipation from this pandemic very soon, but beyond that, what is the kind of use that you foresee for this portal?
Before that, I would like to add one more important information.
Yes, sir.
What you talked about, this data security, it's like a hide and seek game, you know? It is like, I mean, what we play is the chore police game. Like, when you have data, there has to be the issues of data security. Now, as you go, up and up, as and when it is not a static phenomenon, it is a dynamic phenomenon. There will be data breaches. There will be challenges. You develop, there is medicine. When you develop, there is an antidote to the medicine. Similarly, if you have the data, the challenge is that definitely there would be data breaches. And you have to take care of those data breaches also. And then the people who would be looking for breaking those data sets again, they will come up with something. So it is a continuous vicious cycle which goes on. And that's how we evolve in the process. Now, coming to the point what you were talking about is what can we do about it?
Yes.
See, for example, the electronic health record system, what we are talking about, is that at any given junction, today, hardly 2 to 5% or maybe still less of our population that, let's take diabetes, for example. India is supposed to be the diabetes capital of the world. If it is not today, after a few days. But do we have the information to say that how many people are on which kind of diabetic, which pattern of diabetes, or which kind of the anti-diabetic medicine? How is their profile? What is their complications? And all those information, a hell of a lot of information, which is needed for research. And we lack in that. But today, now from Aadhaar, if we can link up to an immunization process, tomorrow we can link up the health data. Simple things is about the maternal and child health services, which is the mostly preventable services, we can add it to them. And gradually we can grow up to curative services.
Right.
And the days are, yes, brighter and brighter day by day.
All right, so that could be the roadmap ahead. But before we sign off, time for closing comments from both my guests. Dr. Raina, coming to you first.
I think the question that you asked, what we can do with this particular application. I think this application can be evolved, can involve and can be developed or scaled up into working as an epidemic intelligence service network. So this can be extended to the to take care of all the epidemics that we see in the future or are currently thinking of will come to us. So it should be an extension of our surveillance network beyond the fact that at this point in time, it's working only on vaccination. So we need to look at this database as the future intelligence surveillance network for epidemics that are going to come to us in near future or in next 5 to 7 years. So we need to develop it to that extent or that level.
All right, let me take that to Dr. Rao. Dr. Rao, this could be developed, as Dr. Rana is saying, as epidemic intelligence network?
Yes, of course. I would definitely foresee that particular thing. See, in the year 2005, we introduced this IDSP, Integrated Disease Surveillance Program. And till today, IDSP is still not able to walk to its fullest potential. Is it still the child is stumbling blocks are happening? The data is either is not being captured properly or the data, whichever has been captured, is not being utilized properly. Because that kind of a challenge had never come up. And this particular situation is coming to us as an add-on. In the past, whatever the mistakes we have done, yes, we are trying to overcome that.
Yes.
And we are looking brighter to the future that we are hopeful that we will be having or we will be creating the gold, the data gold. And we will be in a position to, the pioneer in the globally, we are in a position we can do marvelous things because, as I said, data is gold and we need to do well.
All right. So with another feather in the cap, with COVID going global, let's wrap up the show. Thank you so much for joining us, Dr. Raina and Dr. Rao. So viewers, that's all we had for you in this edition of India Fights Back. But before that, let me remind you once again to stay safe from the coronavirus pandemic. Remember to wear a face mask and wash your hands and face regularly. And ensure that you maintain physical distancing whenever you're stepping outside. These simple precautions are all it takes to defeat this pandemic. Take very good care and goodbye.